Hi friends, this is Anirban. Welcome to my Geeky Anirban channel. Today I will discuss something about the megapixels of a smartphone. Are they really matters? Means are the megapixels really matters in this real world? Let's find out. So the megapixel is in one word is called a 1 million pixels. The resolution of digital cameras and the camera phones are measured in megapixels. For example, a 5 megapixel camera produces images up to 5 million pixels. So do you could really judge the smartphone of the cameras by counting the megapixels? Let's find out. In the real world, this has no meaning. Sometimes the people used to know that the 16 megapixel camera are much better than the 13 megapixel camera. So nowadays the 13 megapixel camera are much better than 16 megapixel camera. So what's the reason behind this? Let's find out. The megapixel of a camera means there are many things that could make the images better, more than a megapixels. First one is that the sensor quality. There are two types of sensors, that are one BSI sensors, one is CMOS sensor. The BSI sensors are much better than the CMOS sensor, whereas the CMOS sensor nowadays are much ahead of the BSI sensors. Second thing is that the aperture. So what is aperture here? Aperture is nothing, an essential opening of a lens diaphragm through which the light passes. Means it produces the image, low light image quality is much better. So in this aperture range there are f1.8, f2.0, f2.2, f2.4. Means f1.8 are much better than f2.0 or 2.2. Means the larger the aperture, the more the pixelation of the images are much better and the crystal clear also. Means the aperture produce the best low light images. Means the larger the aperture, the more the image quality will be the perfect. And third thing is that the sensor size. 1/2.6, 1/2.0, 1/2.8. The larger the sensor size will be the more perfect in the image quality. Means when you will purchase some phone, there has been written that the sensor size means 1/2.3, 1/2.6, you will see that first. Whether it is a low, means whether it is a low or a larger. If there is a 2.3, that means the image quality will be perfect in the sensor size. So before buying a smartphone, see about the sensor size. Then I will come to the OIS or EIS. What is OIS? OIS is nothing, is an optical image stabilization. Means when you are shooting some videos or taking any images in a low light, the OIS will work as a video stabilizer or an image stabilizer. Means there will be no shaking in the videos or in any images. And EIS is called the electronic image stabilization. It is also a same function, but it's in a software part, and OIS is a camera hardware part. Let's come to about the flash. So there are three types of flashes. One is single LED flash, dual tone flash and dual LED flash. Single LED flash is a single flash that gives a single times blink, means the yellow tint it will give. Dual LED flash are the two LED flashes, and dual tone are the more specific flashes that gives a upper flash will be a white or bluish tint. And the under flash, it will be a warmer side or a yellowish tint. Means it will produce the best images in the camera quality. It will help the image in the low light photography also. Let's come about the focus. There are three types of focus, that are laser autofocus, PDF focus, or the laser autofocus plus PDF focus. Once a phone have a laser autofocus plus PDF focus, the image quality will be a perfect, just perfect it will be. And more than that, the image processing is a very much important point in the camera software or a hardware. If you have a phone, the camera hardware are much better, but the imaging processor are low, the camera quality will be at a cheaper side. For example, iPhone have a low hardware quality, means low camera hardware quality, but the imaging processing power is much better. That means the camera on the iPhone, just in one word, it's a perfect. So this is the difference. So before going for a smartphone, specifically for a camera, please think about all these things. First one is that the sensor size, the sensor quality, the aperture, the flash, the OIS or EIS stabilization the phone has or has not, and the focus or the imaging processing. So these things makes the image quality of the phone or a smartphones will be a perfect. So I think it helps to you, and before going for a smartphone to buy, think about these points and then buy. I hope it helps to all of you. So please don't forget to like or don't forget to subscribe, and if any wrong from my side, please note me on a suggestion box. Thank you very much.